own model race cars to encourage STEM education.
Alisa Becerra joins us live this morning in Sacramento. She's getting a little preview. Good morning.
Yeah, well, this is steam, full steam ahead, if you will.
Actually, solar power.
I want to show you. Joining us now, did you get that? Is Jacob Kaditz. You're with SMUD. So this is what students got to work with, right?
That's right. We give them just the basic components, and then it's up to them to come up with creative design to make their car excel either the fastest or the most creative, the most artistic.
And most sustainable.
Most sustainable, that's right.
Okay, I got to get over here because this is what some of these students came up with. So they got this, and they came up with this. And you see Thomas there, who I love. All right, let me get your name.
George.
George, how did you guys come up with this?
It was kind of funny because we were originally building a different type of car, and I was just playing music just for the fun of it. And Thomas the Train came on.
Yeah. Yes.
And since it's like an iconic
symbol, right?
Yes, yeah. From our childhood, we just thought it would be pretty funny to make
nostalgic.
It.
Nostalgic.
Yes.
I love it. Sir Topham Hat would be very happy. All right. Let me get your name.
Ryan.
Ryan. Okay. Tell me about what you guys did here.
We made the tow truck, and so we were planning on making a sports car, but
love them both.
Yeah, it seemed too hard to make a sports car, and so we went with a pickup truck, and I got the idea we should make a tow truck that tows the solar panel as a trailer.
Very creative. What did you guys learn out of this?
Well, we learned how to reuse stuff like cardboard already is used in boxes, so it's sometimes wasted a lot. We want to find a way to make it light, right, and possible to run, but also sustainable.
I love it. Okay, and Xavier, last thing, was it fun?
Definitely, yeah. I would definitely recommend doing this like at home for like a DIY project or something, just because it's like so creative and you could do many things with it.
And you know what? These are our future engineers here, I'm just saying. Okay, and I wanted to show you what this looked like in real life. Okay, so this is also the Laguna Creek team. You guys, can you show me how these run? So we don't have a lot of sun, but 1, 2, 3, go. And there they go. And there they go. All right, let me ask you guys, how are they doing?
They're going pretty slow as of right now since there's not enough sun.
Yeah. Is this part of that learning curve?
Yeah, it'll get easier over time.
But are you pretty happy with your design?
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. It's performing well.
I love it. See, and there you go. Again, they're learning this now at this level, but again later, who knows what these students will be doing. We'll be using their solar power later on.
Back right? To yeah, it is. That's so cool.
Mm-hmm. They're going to be doing big things.
Thanks, Alisa.
Before burning.